Hello everyone, today I'm going to show you how you can create beautiful digital papers in Canva. Go into your Canva workspace. You can use a paper dimension like A4 or postcard or any dimension that you are comfortable working with. So once you have that, you just search for a watercolor background. Okay, and choose one of the many that are available. Okay, I'm going to choose this. Okay, once you have it there, just replace the image as a background. Now we are going to add a few things on top of this. You can actually save this as a digital paper, but where is the creativity in that, right? So we are going to search for some dry flowers, and you can choose any flower from here, and it does not have to match with the colors or anything. You just pick any that you like. And once you're done, what we are going to do is I'm going to just enlarge this a little bit, and I'm going to reduce the transparency. When I am making the digital paper, the main tool that I use is the transparency. I will just reduce the transparency of it such that it blends really nicely with the paper. So now this is okay, it is visible but not so visible kind of thing, but it is something like it is almost blended in with the watercolor background. Okay, now I'm going to add a flower. I'm just going to rotate this a little bit and place it on the bottom. Okay, this is good. I'm going to reduce the transparency again. Notice when you reduce the transparency how the image is still visible, but they are not standing out, but they are blending it with the background. Okay, so this is good enough, but I'm going to add a bit more. Okay, I'm going to add this flowers. Okay, I'm going to add it on top. Now I'm going to reduce the transparency of this as well. Okay, just bring it down enough so that it is blending it nicely, but it is a bit more visible than the other elements. Now I am going to search for Japanese temple. Okay, I'm going to use this. Okay, I'm going to resize this according to my picture. Just place up or position it nicely. If you are able to get rid of the background, that would be optimal. It will look very nice. You don't have to make sure it is fully covering the page if you are able to remove the background. But I'm just going to reduce the transparency and see how it goes. Okay, now you can see it is blending, but then the visibility of that border is very evident. I'm just going to bring it all the way down. Make sure it covers the page. Okay, and then just enlarge it a little bit so it looks nice. And I'm going to reduce the transparency a bit further so that the entire thing blends very nicely. And I'm going to send it all the way back and bring all the other elements to the front. If you're seeing that it is turning into a white background, you have to just do a Command Z so that it will come back up. Okay, now everything is looking nice. I'm going to duplicate this flowers and then place it. I'm going to flip it and place it on the other side. Now it looks very nicely encompassed. Now I'm going to add a small caption over here. This is to just make it my own. Maybe something like a beautiful day awaits. And I'm going to change the color of it. And I want this to blend also. I don't want it to stand out or anything. I just want it to blend in very nicely. I'm just going to change that into a cursive or handwriting font, after which I'm going to enlarge it a little bit and then change the colors. Okay, I'm actually going for the same color palette. I'm going to duplicate this and then give it another shade of the same. Okay, just adjust it such that it is protruding a little from the previous font. And then I'm going to change it to a lighter color. Now you can see that it looks very nice over there. So now this is the template. Now it's ready. Now I will show you some of the other digital papers I have created using the same methods. and these are on sale on my website, and I will provide you with the link in the description box below, and I will show you how you can actually download and use it as your own. So these are all the digital papers that I have made. If you like these designs and would like to purchase them, you can head on over to my website payhip.com/canva-tips-for-you. From there, you will be able to see all my digital templates that are available for download, and from there you can download whatever you like. And I have uploaded two versions of the digital papers, watercolor digital papers, the two different variations. So you'll be able to download a template link, as well as you'll be provided with the PNG files for those bundles. So you can make changes or you can directly print what is available. Once you decide on your purchase, you can actually add to cart and check out. You can pay via PayPal or your credit or debit card. And once you have made the payment, the downloads will be instantly available for you to use. You can use the template or you can use the direct PNG files. It's up to you. If you like this video, please like, share and subscribe. Thank you so much for watching. Bye-bye.